as I was in the process of writing a script for a different video, which will come after this one. Another blockbuster deal was made this offseason. Jamal Adams and a 2022 fourth rounder were traded to the Seattle Seahawks for Bradley McDougal, a first and third round pick in 2021, and a first in 2022. Honestly, it's not a bad return for the Jets by any means, but also not great. McDougal is a starting caliber safety in the league and will automatically start for the Jets come next season, so that is a big plus for them at the very least. They got two first rounders, like I said. They will be late first rounders, probably anywhere from 25 to 32, depending on how deep they go in the playoffs. And a third round pick is just a little incentive for the Jets as well. Now, let's talk about what this means for the Jets. The Jets' future now seems to be bright, as with Jamal Adams, they were going nowhere. Obviously not his fault, but the team around him was just not great. Now that the Jets don't have to pay him, it leaves them with cap room that they would have had to use on Adams, and could have ruined their franchise's future. Jamal is an outstanding safety, probably top three in the league, but paying someone the money he is probably going to get at the safety position can really ruin a team's future as a whole. The Jets now have multiple first-round picks in the next two drafts, which could prove to be astronomical for them, as they will have an early first round in both seasons, and a late one to bolster up their roster. And hey, maybe they'll draft another safety. Who knows? I've heard from people that this is a terrible move for the Jets, but I would like to disagree. The Jets really could use the cap space and draft picks, as currently they're going nowhere as a franchise, really had no future. The draft capital they now have, that could change very quickly. Just a couple of good picks could change a team's future, and Jets now have the draft capital to take some risks on some players that could turn out as stars for them when they come to the NFL, like the Chiefs did with Patrick Mahomes. Also, they can now use the money they are not using on re-signing Jamal Adams on signing veterans coming off of their rookie deals, or proven veterans that are a little older to help the team in the locker room and obviously on the field. The locker room for the Jets is a huge issue, as it seems a good amount of players are not fond of Adam Gase, because I don't think Jamal Adams was speaking alone in those tweets. Gase, in my opinion, is one of the worst coaches in the league. His "I'm rich and you're not" personality really ruins a team's locker room and their culture as a whole, as he doesn't care about anyone else's opinions except for his own, because he has the power to do that, but is the only person who does that, at least to public knowledge. The Jets' best move is to fire him, and to continue to rebuild with the draft capital they have gained, and the cap space they now will have next offseason, hopefully signing players to help out Sam Darnold on the offensive side of the ball, which is what this team really needs to do to see a genuine improvement in the wins category. However, I can see the argument that the Jets' return is bad, as they did only get late first round picks in return and a starting safety, which is not the best return, but for a rebuilding team, to get more draft picks than what they already had, especially first rounders, is good no matter what. I don't care what people have to say about that, first round picks for rebuilding teams is all you can ask, no matter how late they are. The main issue I have is that Bradley McDougal is 29 and will turn 30 in November, so he does not have a lot of time left to be good for the Jets, as well as his contract ending after the season, so the swap for the safeties could be really irrelevant for the Jets, as McDougal could leave after the season, which would just make McDougal a huge negative in this trade. As a whole, I think the Jets' return isn't bad, but not amazing, especially for a player of Adams' caliber. Now, onto the Seahawks. This is just a great move for them. So to contradict myself, which seems like a thing I like to do, all they got rid of was late first round picks, a third, and swap safeties, and got a much better safety than Bradley McDougal. The reason why the first round picks are positive for both teams is because the Seahawks, a team that is already a contender, do not really need the picks, as they already have the team in place that can win right now. And in the past couple years, the Seahawks are notorious for trading first round picks, and they have not really seen any consequences from that. However, the Jets, a rebuilding team, can use all the draft capital they can get to try to turn themselves into a contender. So in reality, the picks help out both teams a lot. Seahawks defense is now very scary. Players like Bobby Wagner, Shaquille Griffin, Bruce Irvin, and Quandre Diggs already on the team. Adding Jamal Adams just makes that group so much better, potentially top 5-7 in the league. The only issue in that defense is the pass rush, but the pass rushers on that team could be good, as they have the potential of Jerron Reed at defensive tackle and LJ Collier on the edge. Defense is improving as the days go on due to the developing young pieces. Also, they can still bring back Jadeveon Clowney. If they do this, the defense is absolutely terrifying for their division in the NFL as a whole. Bring back Clowney and adding Jamal Adams automatically makes them the NFC West division favorites, maybe even the favorite to come out of the NFC. Well, maybe not, but still, I think they're the favorites. Having quarterback Russell Wilson, DK Metcalf, Tyler Lockett, Greg Olsen, who's old and regressing but still reliable, and Chris Carson, the offense, combined with basically a defense that is around 70% of what the Legion of Boom was, watch out NFL, but we got a Super Bowl champion in our hands potentially. To conclude, the Seahawks team as a whole is great, and next season will seem to be a Super Bowl contender with the addition of Jamal Adams, making the team a scary sight in the NFC West and the NFC as a whole. My final thoughts on the trade as of now is that the Seahawks won the trade, because they become automatic Super Bowl contenders. But the Jets did not lose by a lot, because the picks and the cap space it creates helps the rebuild going into the future. That is exactly what they need. And they'll most likely become a much better team in the future than if they kept Jamal Adams. Mostly due to the money he would have taken up in the cap space that they could have used on signing people coming off of their rookie deals that could really help the team out. Instead of just the one player that is phenomenal, but I'd rather have the group of players that could help the team than just one. With all that being said, that is it for me, guys. Thank you for tuning into Fanatic Sports. Hope you all liked the video, and if you did, please subscribe and hit the like button. It only takes 2 seconds. Also, follow me on Instagram, @FanaticSports25, and on Twitter, @FanaticSports. Thank you all for watching. Have a wonderful day.